Next up is ABBYY FlexiCapture batch types. Batch types that you set up in the project setup station. We'll talk about what a batch type consists of, recognition options, pre-processing settings, registration parameters, event handlers, and operator permissions. A batch type is a set of batch processing options. I like to call a FlexiCapture batch type as a project within a project. So a lot of people that are new to FlexiCapture don't take advantage of batch types, and their system might end up less secure and performing less effectively because of that. So when you create a batch type, you can set up multiple document definitions or just a few document definitions. In other words, you can limit which of your project's document definitions are applied at the batch type levels. You can also do different workflow scenarios and pre-processing scenarios. And we'll get back to the permissions aspect of this later, but that's an important part. You can restrict permissions of certain operators to certain project batch types. So by default, there are no batch types in FlexiCapture, and you don't need to create any batch types. Still, a FlexiCapture project has things like workflow properties and pre-processing settings. Where do they get set up? In the project setup station, you click on project and then go down to project properties, and you've got a variety of settings, workflow settings, pre-processing settings that you can manipulate and adjust. That's called the default batch type. We'll drill down and look more closely at the different items in a batch type. We can have a list and order of execution of possible document definitions, image pre-processing settings and verification parameters, event handlers. We'll talk more about that. Export settings, that's really talking about what to do with non-recognized images, because we know that FlexiCapture exports are set up at the document definition level. So at the batch type, we're not talking about setting up a docdefs export destinations, but rather destinations for unknown images, unrecognized images. And we can set up workflows and apply classifiers. So very granular. And I just went over where the default batch type is set up. Event handlers. So that when you set up a batch type, you are walked through a wizard, and each screen of the wizard comports with one of these tabs. And if you want to edit a batch type after it's been created, you can, and you see these various tabs. One of the tabs is the event handler tab, and these are all scripting entry points. So you can apply code at certain points in the workflow. The topmost, let me go back one, the topmost entry point is the batch integrity check. And the batch integrity check allows you to write a script that speaks, that describes what a batch could or should consist of. So since you're scripting, you can do conditional situations where if you get form A and form B, then you need form C. And if those rules aren't adhered to, then there's an error, and you can turn on a batch integrity check workflow queue, a verification queue, where those problems are addressed. So the real meat and potatoes of setting up batch types, I'll describe briefly a scenario. Maybe I have a project and my company needs to automate human resources and manufacturing forms. And let's just say there's 15 human resources forms and 15 manufacturing forms. And by forms, I mean document definitions. So I can set up a batch type for the manufacturing document definitions and one for the human resources document definitions. So how this plays out is each of those document definitions contains only 15, not 30, because the project has 30. So if I set up a hot folder for human resources and I place images in that hot folder. I point that hot folder when I set it up to the human resources document definition batch type. And instead of each image being compared with 30 possible document definitions, it's compared with the 15. So you're going to avoid mismatching. And what if you had a certain scenario where you have a project with 200 document definitions and you have a hot folder that's only going to receive one or two of those documents? So it's very smart to set up a batch type containing only those two document definitions. It's going to speed up matching, and it's going to avoid documents being matched incorrectly. But the operator permissions is a huge part of this, because within one project, I can let, back to my previous scenario, I can set a permission for human resources and one for manufacturing. And in the administration and monitoring console, I can give certain users access to just, let's say the HR folks, just the HR batch type. And similarly, the manufacturing employees only get access to the manufacturing batch type. And that prevents the manufacturing people from accessing human resources batches, which would be a big problem. So I think it's a really great idea to set up batch types to make your system perform more quickly. And another use case is if you get an ingestion, you have an input path, a source of documents that are poor quality of one document and another input path of images that are of high quality of the same document. You want to set up a batch type probably for the poor quality documents, and you do more image pre-processing steps in that batch type, and maybe you alter the verification. You turn on data verification just for the poor quality images, whereas the high quality images, you don't bother with data verification. So I think you see where I'm going with this. It's really a good idea to get familiar with batch types. They can speed up your system. You know what they consist of. You understand what a default batch type is, and you understand how batch types are linked to permissions.